Hi, so in this video we are going to talk about very frustrating error that coders get, time limit exceeded. So we are going to tell you why this happens and how an online judge works and what are the tricks you can use to avoid TLE in your codes. So let's get started.
So in this video we are going to talk about three things: how an online judge works, why do we get a TLE, and how we can avoid TLE by some tricks, right? So let us get started. The first thing is, it is very important to understand the working of an online judge. So there are a lot of online judges like CodeChef, HackerBlocks, HackerRank, HackerEarth. So all of them have a particular system of evaluating submissions. So what happens is, let us say that there is a judge and it is accepting a submission for a given problem. So suppose you're giving it a submission S, and for this submission the judge has some input and some output files already with it, right? So what it does is, judge gives the submission to the processor. So the submission goes to the processor, and this processor has some processing limits. Suppose in 1 second it can perform up to 10^8 operations. So this limit is generally fixed for most of the online judges, and in 1 second it is capable of performing 10^8 operations. So what happens is, when the submission goes to the processor, right? So your program executes and it gets the input and it generates some output. Let's call it O and let's call it O dash. And your judge tries to match if the given output matches with the actual output, right? So if it is matches, then it is a case of a correct answer, you get a AC. But during the execution, if the judge thinks that your program has taken more time than the required limit, right? So if the required limit was 1 second and your program is taking more than 1 second, then your judge will issue a kill command. So it will kill the process, and in the output you will get a TLE. You will get that time limit has been exceeded than the given limit, right? So this is how you get a TLE. In that case, all the input files are not evaluated. As soon as a test case or a program exceeds the limit, you get a TLE, right? So this TLE response is sent back to the client, and all the responses, whether it be AC or TLE or compilation error, these are sent via the server to the client, right? So this is how the online judge works, and the idea is to make sure that you have to stop processing after a particular time, right? You cannot have processing in infinite amount of time. Whatever the algorithm is written, it must run in some finite amount of time, and it should be optimized, right? Suppose you want to compute, you want to check if a number is prime or not, and number is of the order 10^18, and you are using a ON algorithm, you are bound to get a TLE. And if you use a O of log n algorithm, you will get accepted, because log of 10^18 is going to be around 60, right? So this algorithm will pass and this will not pass. So ensuring that you get a TLE helps you to optimize your algorithm, right? So this is why and how you get a TLE. Now I'm going to talk about few things using which you can avoid TLE. The first thing is, analyze the constraints. So you have to analyze the constraints of the problem very carefully, right? And it is given that in 1 second, if the time limit is 1 second, your processor is capable of doing 10^8 operations, right? Now let us talk about three things. Let us say the value of n. What is the worst complexity we can have for this value of n? And some example, right? Let me give you some example of that algorithm also, right? So let us say n is very less. The value of n is less than equal to 10. So if n is less than equal to 10, the worst complexity you can have is O of n factorial. Right? This is the worst case algorithm you can have, or you can have O of 2 raised to the power n. Example is finding permutations or generating subsets. You can generate subsets of a set. This is one example, right? Suppose n is of the order n is less than equal to 18, then the worst complexity you can have is O of 2 raised to the power n into n square. Example of this is a traveling salesman problem with GP, right? So in traveling salesman problem, we solve this problem in this complexity, and this will work if n is less than equal to 18. Let us say that n is less than equal to 22. So in this case, the worst case algorithm can have complexity of O of 2 raised to the power n into n, right? An example of this is this kind of technique is used in DP with bit masking, right? So DP with bit masks. So I have made one tutorial on it, the t-shirts problem from CodeChef, right? This you can watch. And let us say n is less than equal to 100, then your algorithm must not have more than n4 iterations, right? So this is the worst complexity you can have, right? An example of this is you can have 4 nested loops. Any problem which involves 4 nested loops. And let us say n is less than equal to 400, then the complexity is O of n cube. An example of this is Floyd Warshall algorithm, right? Using dynamic programming. It uses a n cube solution, right? And let us say n is less than equal to 2000. Then you can have an algorithm which is of the maximum complexity O of n square log n, right? So this complexity example is that you use two nested loops with binary search. So nested loops work in n square plus binary search takes logarithmic time plus binary search you can do, right? Let us talk about n is less than equal to 10 power 6 or let's say 10 power 5. In that case, you can have a algorithm like let us say 10 power 4, right? O of n square, right? Because for a given value of n, you are making 10 power 8 iterations, which will get accepted. Example is bubble sort or insertion sort, or maybe any algorithm which uses two nested loops. Let us talk about n is less than equal to 10 power 6 or is of the order 10 power 5, 6, right? In that case, you can have a algorithm which is either O(n) or at max O of log n, right? So this is the maximum limit. Example is a greedy strategy, right? Or a sorting algorithms like merge sort, sorting in n log n, right? So these type of problems are covered in this range. And let us talk about little more. Let's say n is less than equal to 10 power 8, right? So in that case, the expected complexity is either O n or O of log n or O of 1, right? So examples you can identify, right? And let us say n is of the order 10 power 18. So in that case, you can have a O of log n solution or you can have a O of 1 solution. Example is to compute nth Fibonacci number using matrix exponentiation. This you can do, right? And in this case, you could also have a linear DP problem, right? Linear DP. Right. And this is how, by analyzing the constraints, you can choose an algorithm and you can think of what is the worst complexity of the algorithm I can have by analyzing the constraints. So this is the first method. The second method is you can use fast input output. Sometimes it is not only about the algorithm. So 90% of the times it is about the algorithm, but sometimes it is also about the input output method, right? So the next trick you can use is the input output, fast input output, right? So in C++ and C, there are methods for taking fast input, right? So in Java, in C, you can also use scanf and printf, right? You can also use fast IO, right? And in Java, it is always preferred to have a buffered reader, right? You can have a buffered reader for Java, right? And the constraints on the time limit also are dependent upon the language you are coding in, right? For example, if the C++ takes 1 second, the same program in Java might take 2 seconds, right? And in Python, it might take 4 seconds. That's why problem setters set different limits for different languages, because Python is a relatively slow language. C and C++ are relatively fast because of their being more closer to the hardware. So I hope you will use these tricks in your problem, and thank you for watching.
I hope you enjoyed learning from this tutorial. So hit the like button and do not forget to subscribe our channel Coding Blocks India on YouTube. For more such tutorials, visit our website codingblocks.org. Thank you.